Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's speed up your web browsing with 50 time-saving Safari shortcuts. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So there are so many different keyboard and cursor shortcuts for Safari, but let's focus on some that will make it faster to navigate around web pages and tabs.
So let's start by looking at the largest key in your keyboard, the space bar. If you hit the space bar while viewing a web page and you're not editing text in some field like a search field here, it will advance to the next page. So you could see hitting the space bar over and over again will advance page by page so you could read the text there. If you hold the shift key down and press space bar, it goes in the opposite direction, one page up to get back to the top. If you want to advance in smaller increments, you can use the down arrow. Down arrow will advance by about a line. And up arrow will go up a line. If you hold the Option key down and press the down or up arrow, you get pages. So it is the same as spacebar or shift spacebar to use Option down or Option up. If you use the Command key and down, it goes all the way to the bottom of the web page. And Command up will go all the way to the top. What about the left and right arrow keys? Well, by themselves they don't do anything, but if you do Command left, it's the same as hitting the back button here. If you do Command right, it's the same as hitting the forward button. So if you look under the history menu, you see that the back and forward buttons actually have shortcuts that are Command left bracket and right bracket. So those do the same thing. Command left bracket and right bracket are back and forward, just the same as Command left and Command right. Now if I use Command, Shift, and the right arrow, it actually goes through the tabs. So notice I've got four tabs now open at the top. If I do Command, Shift, right arrow, it goes to the next tab, the next tab, the next tab, and it will circle back to the first one. If I use the left arrow, so Command, Shift, left arrow, it just goes through them backwards. Now if you look in the Window menu, you notice that Show Next Tab is actually Control Tab. And previous tab is Control Shift Tab. So those do the same thing. If I do Control Tab, it goes to the next one and it circles through. If I do Control Shift Tab, it goes backwards through them. Now you can jump to a tab by doing Command and then a number key. So Command and 3 jumps to the third tab. Command 1 will jump to the first tab. And you can do that all the way up to Command 8. Command 9 will actually jump to the ninth tab if you have 9 tabs open, but will also jump to the last tab in any case. So if you have 13 tabs open, Command 9 will jump to the 13th tab. If you have 4 tabs open like I have here, Command 9 will jump to the 4th tab. Now to create a new tab, there's a really handy keyboard shortcut, Command T. This creates a new tab and allows you to enter a URL to go to. If you want to get to the URL field on any page, like a page that you're already at, you can just do Command L. This instantly gives you access to the field here where you can start a search or type a new URL. Now a lot of people don't know that you can move tabs around. So if you wanted this third tab here to actually be second, you can click and drag the tab to the left and move it around. These are all rearrangeable. And when you click a link, it will go to the web page in the current tab. But you can hold down some modifier keys to do some different things. They're going to work differently for different people because of some settings. So go into Safari Preferences and then click on Tabs. And you'll see a list here of 4 different modifiers. For instance, I've got it set so Command Click will open a link in a new tab. Now these 4 things will change depending upon these 2 check marks here. So for instance, if I have both of them unchecked, you'll see that Command Click will open a link in a new window. If I select this, it will open a link in a new tab. If I select this, it will open a link in a new tab and make it the active tab. If I unselect the first check mark here, it opens a link in a new window and makes it the active window. So you can see there are 4 variations depending upon how I have each of these checked. So Command Shift Click is another thing that will change with these different checkboxes here. Command Option Click and Command Option Shift Click. So you have 4 different ways to modify how a click works, and you can change them by using these checkboxes here. So it's all a matter of whether you prefer windows or tabs, and whether or not when you click something you want to jump to that window or tab, or just have that open up in the background. Now to close a tab, you can use Command W, which is the standard keyboard shortcut for closing a window or tab. So Command W will close this tab. Now if you accidentally do that, you can use undo to get it back. Because if you look at edit, undo, you can see it changes to undo, close tab, command Z, since that was the last thing I did. So command Z will bring that tab back. The same thing happens for Windows. So I can use command N for a new window. So now I have a new browser window. And if I go to a page there, I can close it with command W. Now if you prefer using Windows instead of tabs, you can always open a new window with command N. And now you can see I've got two browser windows. And I could go to a page here. I can open up tabs in this window. And I can close this window here since there's only one tab. A command W will close the tab, meaning that the entire window is gone. The standard way to switch between windows in Mac apps is to use command and the key to the left of the one key on US keyboards. So command and that key will switch between windows just like you were switching between tabs. And if I have even more windows open, I can switch between all of these windows, cycle through them with command and that key to the left of the one, and using shift will go the opposite way through them. Now while you can use undo to bring back a tab you just closed, undo won't work for a closed window. However, under history, you've got shift command T to reopen the last closed window. Now there are a few shortcuts that'll take you directly to a web page without you having to set anything up. If you look under bookmarks and then you go to favorites, you'll see that the first 9 favorites listed here have keyboard shortcuts assigned. So in this case, Option Command 1, Option Command 2, all the way to Option Command 9. But do note that if under preferences in tabs, if you uncheck this, so you're not using Command 1 through Command 9 to switch between tabs, then under bookmarks, the option goes away. It's simply Command 1 through Command 9 that will be used to go to those. So if you really want to control what these are, you can go into Edit Bookmarks and under Favorites here, you can change the order of these, move these around, change what they go to, so you can get those 9 keyboard shortcuts matched up to websites that you commonly go to. Now if you have an absolute favorite page that you go to all the time, you can go to Safari Preferences and under General you can set up that page as your home page. Then you've got the keyboard shortcut for Home, which is Shift Command H to quickly go to that page. If you want to go back in time and go to your history, you've got these buttons here. And a handy thing to be able to do is click one to go back one page. But if you click and hold, it'll actually show you a list of the complete history of that tab that you have selected. And the same is true of the forward button. Now, if you hold down the Option key and click these, then instead of getting the page titles, you get the actual URLs of the pages. You can also go look at all of your history, and you could do that with the keyboard shortcut Command Y. Now once you're on a web page, sometimes the page is so large that it's hard to find the piece of information you want in it. You can search inside of a web page by using Command F. This opens up a little search box here and you can immediately type into it. And as you type, you get results. So it'll jump to the first result. So I'm looking for Einstein here, but I only had to type 3 letters. It tells me there are 3 matches. It gives me little buttons to go back and forth between those matches and a done button to dismiss. And you can see it highlights the word where it finds it. Now the menu items for this are under Edit, Find. So you can see here there's Command F and there's also Command G to find next and Shift Command G to find the previous one. Now to make a web page easier to view, you can use Command and Plus. It's actually Command and Equals to enlarge the page so you can see the text get a lot bigger. Command and minus make it smaller again, and command 0 will actually take it to its real regular size. You can also do shift command R to go into reader view for a page, and then the same shift command R will take you out of reader view. Now if you ever need more space for entering in text, like in a form like this, notice that some text fields you'll see these 2 little lines in the bottom right hand corner. This means you can drag to resize the box. Now when you download something, you'll get a little download icon here. So I'll click here to download this PDF and you can see I get downloads here. I can click on it and see the downloads. I could click the little magnifying glass here to jump right to it, which is in the downloads folder. But I could also click and drag the icon right in here and I could drag it to a Finder window to move it out of the downloads folder to the place I want it. Now if you ever want to reload a page, which is particularly useful if you're following breaking news and the page is changing all the time, then you can use View and Reload Page or Command R to reload it. But if you hold the Option key down, so Command Option R, it reloads the page from the origin, meaning that instead of taking graphics and other elements from your browser cache, it will reload all of those. So it's a complete page reload. Now I'm going to finish with another way to handle tabs, which is to use Command and Shift and then the backslash. That brings up the tab overview and you could see all the tabs open in the current window. And one of the cool things about this page is once you're here you can do Command F and now you get Search Tabs. And you can use it to search but only the title of the tab. So for instance if I were to look for Einstein it wouldn't find it because it's not in the title of this page but in the content. If I search for Apple it will find both of these tabs because the word Apple appears in the title for both tabs. Now I've got one last one for you. If you search using the search field at the top of Safari and then you view the search results in the search engine of your choice, you can go to a page and then you can get back to the search result using search result snapback. So Option Command S takes you back to your search results. So if you're doing a complex search and you keep looking into web pages, not finding the information you need, you can use that shortcut to jump back to the search results. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.